Hello student, with a pleasant morning, I welcome you all on the video lecture class. Student, we have completed our 2 chapter in English literature. That chapter was completely completed and the exercises I hope so that you have given. The chapter number 3, that is Journey by Night, the chapter name is written over here. It's chapter number 3, Journey by Night. So today we will start this chapter. We will come to know about the character of this chapter and what is this chapter actually is. So student, before starting this chapter, I just want to tell you some typical words that are written over here. Timber, accompany, groaning, ring, glassy, sling, post, drenched, slimy, wretch, bragging, remains, expedition, going, start it, die out, beast of prey, run out of the steam. So these are the words that are written over here. You have to write the meaning of these words. So let's start. Have you ever been on a journey through the night? Discuss with your partner. So this is the question to you, that have you ever been any journey? So you have to discuss these type of the experiment, these type of the things with your partner and with your friend. So the title of this chapter denotes that what is the gist of the chapter, what is the theme of the chapter. So the story is divided in different parts. There are 4 parts of this story. So the first part of this one, so through this chapter we will come to know different types of the journey, different types of the traveling that we have through night. So here we are seeing that the characters, Sher Singh Bahadur, it's a central figure in this story, and he had two sons, Sher Singh and Kumar. Okay, these are the name of his two sons. These are the name of his two sons, Sher Singh and Kumar, and he has his beautiful wife. And also the village people, also the folk people or the village people. So let's see what is actually in the story, what is about it in the story. So we are going to explain you the story, so please pay attention, please concentrate towards your book. You have to point out each and every word with your finger so that you come to know what the story actually is. So you have to open page number 26, chapter number 3. This is your book. Sher Singh Bahadur lived in a mud and grass house with his wife and 2 sons. So he was very poor. He was in a miserable condition. He was in a pitiable condition. What was the condition? How can we come to know that he was poor? Because I have read only 1 line before you. So how can you come to know that Sher Singh Bahadur was very poor? So we come to know this thing by the line that I have read before you in just now, because it's written over here that he lived in mud and grass, the house that was constructed of mud and grass, and he was living with his wife and his 2 sons. And what was the name of his 2 sons? Children, what was the name of his 2 sons? The name of his 2 sons were Sher Singh and Kumar. Have you got it? Sher Singh and Kumar in the Lanchwani village. So this was the place, this was the venue where he was lived. Like most villagers, they managed to keep body and soul together by grazing cattle and cultivating land. This was his occupation, this was the earning source, this was the source of earning money by which he was surviving themselves, his 2 sons and his wife, like this. So what was the way of earning money? What was the way of keeping themselves together like this? So the meaning of this one, keep body and soul together. It means to say to manage to survive with his very little money. Body and soul together when you have very little money, and in that little money you have to manage all the things. This is the meaning of that. Keep body and soul together. This is the meaning of that thing. Keep body and soul together. So he had very little money. That's why it was really difficult. It was really difficult and really impossible to survive themselves in such a little amount. But it was really hard to manage. But he managed. He had to be managed all these things. So the meaning of keep body and soul together, it means he was just surviving. He was really facing different several types of the difficulties and anxieties and calamity in his life, and he was just facing all these things. But what was the main source of earning? What was the main source of main occupation of Sher Singh? The main source was that he was earning only by grazing cattle and cultivating land. So he was working cultivating the land. He was grazing. He was busy grazing cattle. Cattle is a group of the animals. So it was just source of earning, and through this way he was living. He was surviving. Fine. And one more thing is that Sher Singh Bahadur had been given the title Bahadur. His name was Sher Singh Bahadur, and because he was surviving, he was doing hard work, he was the laborious type of the person. That's why he had given a title, and the title was according to his name, Bahadur. And for his act of bravery as a famous shikari. So because of he was very courageous, he was very bold, he was strong enough to face all type of the situation. He was never movable. He always be static. That is why he got a title, and the title was Shikari and Bahadur. So this was the reason most hunting and photography expedition asked him to accompany them into the jungle. So this was the reason. This was the most prominent thing that expeditions mean journey undertaken by a group of people with a particular purpose. So he used to go into the jungle for the particular purpose, and he didn't go there alone. He went there with many people of the village. So expedition, because if someone goes somewhere because of having some particular purpose, so this is the meaning expedition. Fine. So he daily went to jungle for that purpose, because he had to raise the cattle, and he had to cultivate the lands like this. So next line, it was sometime in the day that Kumar took ill. So it's happened that his Kumar, that was his younger son, he got ill. He fell sick. Their father had gone into the jungle with a wildlife photography group along with all the men from the village, beating drums and other instruments to scare and scatter the animal out of the hiding. So his father had been gone to jungle for hunting, and many of the people also went with him. So what was the thing that he went for the wildlife photography? When we chase any animal at that time, a live photography, at that time we just click the picture of that one. That was a very unique picture, that was very different picture, a specific type of the pic that we took at that time. That is the wildlife photography. And many of the people were there, and they started beating drums, and other instruments were there. It was only for that. They cannot save themselves. They cannot save themselves. They cannot hide themselves. This was the reason, so that they can scatter. They can't collect anyone because of hearing the sound, because of hearing of the noise. They cannot stay any longer anywhere. This was the reason behind that. Little Kumar lay on a chapai, groaning with stomach pain. Chapai, that's a pot, you know. You people have at your home also. So groaning, a deep sound made when in a pain, when you have a severe pain, either at any part of the body, you started groaning. It means that is falling the karana. So when he was groaning at that time, he was just giving a deep sound of pain when you have a severe pain at any part of the body. So Kumar Singh fell ill at that time, and he had stomach pain at that time. His suffering was clear to his mother, who listened to his cries helplessly. His suffering, his, his pain, his pitiable condition, his miserable condition, and his ache was only clear to his mother, because she was his mother. Only mother can know the burden of yours, which type of the burden, which type of the pain, which type of the pathetic condition you have in your life. Only your mother can listen to it. That's why she was listening it, but she was helpless. She was helpless because she could not do anything for that. She didn't have solution of that, because she was alone at home. She was alone. His son was there, but he was too little to do anything. So 12 years old, Sher Singh helped his mother wring out rats in boiling water and place them on towards his stomach for relief. So Sher Singh was helping his mother, and he was helping in wringing out the rats in boiling water and place them on towards his stomach. So whenever we put any rags, lacings, torn cloths, dirty cloths, that when we drop that cloth into the water, and when we take it out and we wring it tightly, and he put that cloth on the stomach of poor Singh for some relaxation, for some relief. Fine. So his son was helping him. Much younger than Sher Singh. He was really much younger, and Kumar, much younger than Sher Singh, had gone almost silent, and his eyes held a glassy pour of a state. So he was much more younger than Sher Singh, and he had gone almost silent. He was silent at that time and held a glassy, and glassy pour of a state, it means his eyes was not giving any expression. We cannot see any feeling and expression, and it was not showing any interest or feeling. And because of the fever, her look pale and her eyes held a glassy for a stare. So his face was looking faded. He was looking pale at that time. It looks there is no drop of blood on his face. So he was looking that he is getting more worse. He is getting worse and worse at the time. So it was seen that time, mother, let me run and get father, said Sher Singh. Sher Singh said at that time, please let me go from there, and I'm going to be my father. I'm going to call my father. It may take you days to find him. The jungle is dense. The jungle is very deep. You will be, you could not be able to find him in a very easy way, because it will take days and days. Kafi time lag jayega tumhe unhe paane mein, his mother replied. Kumar needs a hospital. It's time he needs a hospital urgently, because his condition is not good. He is getting worse and worse, and he must be taken to Golaghat. It's the name of the hospital, I think so. So he must be hospitalized at that time. So Sher Singh knew that the hospital at the Golaghat was 50 miles away across the jungle. So it was 50 miles away from across the jungle. When he crossed the jungle, so from the jungle it was 50 miles away from there. So it was really very distance from there. We cannot reach there. Two rivers and some distance ahead. There was so in the way of that we have to cross two rivers, and then after we will move to that hospital. All the men of the village are away. Mother, and you have to stay here to mind the cattle and land. I'll take care of myself. So he's saying here that please, mom, make me allowed to go. Make me allowed to go from here. You have to stay at home, and you have to take care of yourself, your cattle, and I'll go with the poor myself. I'll go there. This was a decision. It's too big for you. How will you manage, son? How will you manage? It's too big for you. I don't think you will get there. You have to remain here. I'll go. Her voice dropped to a sad whisper, because he didn't want to give her acceptance willingly, but he just whispered. Whispered, "Fuspusana, dheeme se," usne bola, in a sad, in a very silent voice, she replied. Sher Singh was determined. Sher Singh was, it was his firm determination that I had to go anyhow. I had to save the life of my brother. I had to go, mother. There is no time to lose. We will not lose even a single of minute, because each and every minute is very important for our brother. And it was almost evening. It was the time of evening. It's getting dark and dark. And his mother made a sling from her sarees, and he just torn her saree and take out a cloth of peace from her saree, lifted Kumar and placed him in the sling of Kumar's bag. Also Kumar ki bag mein usko rakh diya. His mother was right. Sahi, Kumar was happy. Kumar was heavy weighted, and Sirishi wondered if he had beaten off more than he could chew. So Kumar Singh knew their thing. Now he had to beaten off more things than he chewed. Iska matlab ye hai ki usko ab utni zyada cheeze swallow karni hai jitni wo chew bhi nahi kar sakta. It means to say he was too young to have a burden upon his shoulder. And he was going to get more responsibilities and more burden upon his shoulder according to his age. But he was going to do this thing. That was really impressive. That was a matter of adventure and an encouraging matter. It's a matter of his strong willpower, his vigor, and his enthusiastic nature. So student, you have seen that whenever we are taking on more responsibility than we can handle, it's really a matter of appreciation. It's really a matter of praiseworthy. So you have seen that how we had done it. So the first part of this chapter is completed. We will continue the second part of this chapter in our next lecture. I hope so that you have got this chapter very well. It's very interesting and curious story. I hope so that you are curious to come to know what will happen in the next part. So that is enough for you today. Thank you, and have a nice day to all.
Good morning, student. Welcome to Shivaji Group of Institution online classes. Student, in previous class we have completed the theoretical part of chapter 3. Now today we will discuss its exercise 3.1. So we will start with filling the blanks. Now first statement is the ratio between the dash and dash is called pressure. Student, as you know that the formula of pressure equal to force divided by area. So the ratio between the force and area of cross section. Area of cross section is called pressure. Now second statement, when a force of 1 dash acts on an area of cross section 1 meter square, the pressure exerted is said to be 1 dash. Student, as we have discussed earlier that when a force of 1 newton, acts on an area of cross section of 1 meter square. 1 meter square, or we can say 1 Pascal. So here Newton acts on an area of cross section 1 meter square. The pressure exerted is said to be 1 Pascal. 1 Pascal. Now third statement is the cutting edge of cutting instruments is sharpened because by dash the area of cross section dash increases. Student, as you know that pressure equal to force divided by area of cross section. And when area of cross section is decreased, then pressure will be increased. So the cutting edge of cutting instruments is sharpened because by area of cross section decreasing the area of cross section, the pressure increases. Now fourth statement, the broad tires of tractor dash pressure on the soft ground and hence prevent it from dash in the given ground. Student, when there is broad tires, it means its area of cross section is more. P is equal to force divided by area of cross section. Student, when area of cross section is more, then pressure will be decreased because area of cross section is inversely proportional to pressure. So the broad tires of tractor reduce pressure on the soft ground and hence prevent it from sinking in the ground. Now next statement is, with the increase in force, the magnitude of pressure on a given area dash. Student, as we know that pressure is directly proportional to force. So when pressure is increased, when force is increased, then pressure will increase, and force is decreased, then pressure is decreased. So with the increase in force, the magnitude of pressure on a given area increases. Now, true or false? First statement is, thrust per unit volume is called pressure. Student, this statement is false because thrust per unit area is called pressure. So this statement is false. Now second statement, 1 pascal is the pressure produced by a force of 1 kilogram force on a surface of 1 meter square. Student, this statement is also false because 1 pascal is the pressure produced by a force of 1 newton on a surface of 1 meter square. So this statement is false. Now next statement, pressure increases with the increase in surface area. This statement is false because pressure increases with the decrease in surface area. Student, as you know that area of cross section is inversely proportional to pressure. So when area of cross section is increased, then pressure will be decreased, and area of cross section is decreased, then pressure will be increased. So pressure increases with the increase in surface area, and this statement is false. Now next statement, pressure decreases with the increase in the weight of an object. Student, this statement is also false because pressure decreases with the decrease in the weight of an object. So this statement is false. Now next statement, SI unit of pressure is Newton. No, SI unit of pressure is Pascal. So this statement is false. Now sixth statement, long skis used by skiers reduce the pressure on snow. Student, this statement is true because the area of cross section of long skies is more, so it reduces the pressure on snow. This statement is true. Now, seventh statement is the broad side on thumb tack increase the pressure on the thumb. Student, this statement is false because the broad side on thumb tack decrease the pressure on the thumb. So this statement is false. Now, eighth statement is a blunt nail easily penetrate in wood than sharp nail. Student, this statement is false because the area of cross section of blunt nail is more than sharp nail, so its pressure is reduced, so its pressure is decreased. So this statement is false. Now, ninth statement is the edge of knife is sharpened to increase the pressure. Student, this statement is true because the area of cross section of edge of knife is less, so its pressure will increase. So this statement is true. Now, tenth statement is foundation of high-rise building are small. This statement is false because foundation of high-rise buildings are big. Now, student, tick the correct option. First statement is with the increase in the weight of an object, the pressure increases, decreases is not affected, and none of these. Student, the correct option is increases. With the increase in the weight of an object, the pressure will increases. Now, second statement, with the increase in the area of contact of an object, the pressure increases, decreases is not affected, and none of these. Student, the correct option is B, which is decreases. Now, third statement, 1 pascal is the pressure generated by force of 1 newton on 1 meter square and force of 1 kilogram force on 1 meter square and force of 1 newton on 1000 centimeter square and force of 1 newton on 1 centimeter square. Student, as you know that 1 pascal is the pressure generated by force of 1 newton on 1 meter square. So the correct option is A. Now, fourth statement is, in order to glide on snow, one must wear spiked shoes, flat rubber shoes, flat and long skies, and none of these. Student, the correct option is C, which is flat and long skies. And fifth statement, the rear wheels of tank trailer have large number of wheels so that they can withstand the load of tank and reduce pressure on the road and increase pressure on the road and all of these. Student, the correct option is reduce pressure on the road. Now, student, match the following. First statement, buildings having very wide foundation. Student, the correct match is C, which is high-rise buildings. Now, second statement, tools having very small surface area. The correct option is E, which is cutting tools. Now, third statement is the ratio of thrust and area of cross section is called pressure. The correct match is D, which is pressure. pressure. And fourth statement, the unit of pressure in SI system is Pascal. So the correct match is B. And decreasing the pressure exerted by an object without changing its area of contact. Student, the correct option is A, which is reducing force. So student, today's class is over. Thank you.
Hello student, welcome to FUI online chemistry classes for class 8. Student, let's continue the chapter number 3, that is the element, compound and mixture. And today I am going to start a new type of new technique of separation, that is the separation by filtration. In previous video, I was explaining you the separation method by which is sedimentation and decantation. Let's revise it. What is sedimentation? Sedimentation is a process in which the particles present in suspension is going to be shuttled down in a bottom of a beaker. And that particles which are collected at bottom is known as sediment, and that clear solution is known as supertended liquid, and this process is known as sedimentation process. And the separation of sediment particles and clear solution is known as the process of decantation. Okay, now that method, what method? Sedimentation method and decantation method is used for the mixture. What type of mixture? Mixtures of suspension. What is suspension? Suspension is the type of mixture in which we can easily identify, we can easily see the presence of component present in that mixture. Now today I am going to start separation by filtration. So we deal with filtration. What is filtrate and what is residue? Student, let's take an example. The mixture of sand and water. Okay. First of all, what is filtration? Filtration is the process. A process in which we can separate the residue and the clear solution. Residue present in the liquid solution by using filter paper. Filter paper ka use karke, what is filter paper? Abhi batati hu. Filter paper ka use karke, residue particle, residue means impurities present in that liquid. Us liquid mein jo impurities present hai, jinko hum log residue particles keh rahe hain, usko filter paper ka use karke separate karna hi kya kehlata hai? Filtration kehlata hai. Okay student, chalte hain. एक एग्जांपल लेते हैं. एक यहां पे बीकर लिया, ओके, वीट क्ले का बीकर व्हिच इज फिल्टर्ड विद वाटर एंड सम इंप्यूरिटीज प्रेजेंट इन दैट वाटर व्हिच इज नोन एज रेसिड्यू. दीज इंप्यूरिटीज आर नोन एज रेसिड्यू एंड इट इज वाटर. ओके, नाउ वी कैन सेपरेट दीज टू थिंग्स. We can separate residue from that water by using filter paper. Filter paper is a circular paper. Okay, ये एक circular paper होता है, in which some pores present in, जिसमें कुछ pores present होते हैं, and that pores, इनका जो pore size होता है, वो इस residue particle को अपने से pass नहीं होने देता है. Residue particle does not passes through that pores. Only water allow it passes from that pores. Okay. Use कैसे करते हैं? सबसे पहले इस circular paper जिसमें कि some pores present हैं, उसको हम लोग इस तरीके से double fold कर देते हैं. कैसे fold किया? इस तरीके से fold कर देते हैं. ये double folded है. Okay. Now इसको हम कोन शेप में, ये जो एज है दोनों, इसको इस तरीके से करते हैं कि ये कोन शेप में आपका बच्चों बन जाता है. Yes, इसको जो हम लोग यूज करते हैं फिल्टर पेपर को, इन विच सम पोर्स आर प्रेजेंट, इसको हम सबसे पहले कोनिकल फॉर्म में लाते हैं. तो आपको आई होप समझ में आ गया. व्हाट इज फिल्टर पेपर? पेपर होता है जिसमें सम पोर प्रेजेंट होते हैं. इसको यूज कैसे करते हैं? डबल फोल्ड करके कोन शेप में बना के उसको हम यूज करते हैं. ओके, नाउ इट इज आयरन स्टैंड, स्टैंड है इन विच फनल इज अटैच्ड. व्हाट इज फनल बच्चों? फनल एक इंस्ट्रूमेंट होता है जिसमें हम इस कोनिकल फिल्टर पेपर को एडजस्ट करते हैं. इसके अंदर हमने क्या ऐड किया? अपना कोनिकल फिल्टर पेपर, ये फनल है. ओके, दिस इज फनल इन विच व्हाट इज प्रेजेंट? कोनिकल फिल्टर पेपर इज प्रेजेंट. यहाँ पे हम लोग एक बीकर को प्लेस करते हैं, विच इज ब्रैकेट, ब्रैकेट बीकर लेते हैं, और यहाँ फनल में से हम इस मिक्सचर को पास करते हैं. रिमेम्बर स्टूडेंट, इस फनल के अंदर कॉनिकल फिल्टर पेपर हम लोगों ने प्रेजेंट, हम लोगों ने इसके अंदर डाल रखा है. ओके, अब इस बीकर को इन विच सम रेसिड्यूज आर प्रेजेंट, इसमें से हम पोर कराते हैं. ओके, यहाँ पे हमने ये मिक्सचर, मिक्सचर ऑफ रेसिड्यू एंड वाटर इन विच रेसिड्यूज आर प्रेजेंट को हमने इससे इज अलाउड टू पास फ्रॉम फिल्टर पेपर. फिल्टर पेपर इन विच सम पोर्स आर प्रेजेंट एंड दैट पोर्स ओनली अलाउ द वाटर पासेस थ्रू फ्रॉम इट, नॉट रेसिड्यू पार्टिकल. सो जब मैंने ये फिल्टर पेपर जिसमें सम पोर्स प्रेजेंट थे उसमें से मिक्सचर ऑफ वाटर एंड रेसिड्यू को पास कराया, उन पोर्स ने केवल वाटर को अलाउ किया, अपने से रेसिड्यू पार्टिकल्स उस फिल्टर पेपर में बचे रह जाएंगे. ओके, तो यहाँ पे बच्चों इस फिल्टर पेपर में क्या बचा रह जाएगा? सिर्फ ओनली बचा रह जाएगा रेसिड्यू पार्टिकल्स. वेयर एज जो वाटर प्रेजेंट था इस मिक्सचर में वो कहाँ पे कलेक्ट हो जाएगा? कलेक्ट हो जाएगा इस बीकर में. ओके बच्चों, so I hope you understand the first meaning, that is what is filtration. Filtration is the process in which we separate the residue from that present in that liquid by using filter paper like this. So bachchon, what is filtrate? Filtrate, that clear solution, that clear solution is known as filtrate, and the impurities, this residue, this impurities is known as residue which is present in mixture. So it is complete bachcho. What is that is the number D method, separation by filtration. In next video I will start next type of technique of separation. Okay, I hope you understand what is filtration, what is filtrate, what is residue. Thank you.
Welcome to you, Shivaji Group of History Tips Online Classes. Students, this is your history class. Today, I will teach you Chapter 4, India in 18th Century. Chapter 4, India in 18th Century. Today, we discuss about India in 18th Century. In what condition? In India in 18th century. Understand? Now students, first we discuss about some motivational lines, that all of us have, all of us have, don't, yani all of us don't have equal talent. मतलब हम सबके पास क्या होता है? इक्वल टैलेंट नहीं होता, बट वी हैव इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू, वी हैव टू इक्वल अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू डेवलप आवर टैलेंट. अंडरस्टैंड? आई रिपीटेड दिस लाइंस कि ऑल ऑफ अस डोंट हैव इक्वल टैलेंट, बट ऑल ऑफ अस have equal opportunities to prove your talent. Understand? Now students, so work hard and get your success. Now
India incurred the phase of transition. The phase of transition. Because the 18th century represents, and 18th century represents a phase of transition between medieval and modern periods. Medieval and modern periods, so students, the history and the time period of the history divided into three parts. First, ancient period, second, medieval period, and third, modern period. So the 18th century is also the phase of transitions, the phase of transitions between, mani kiske between ka time hai, medieval and modern period. Any 18th century is also called the time period of between any Middle Age and the Modern Age. Understand? In India, 18th century is the characterized by the decline of Mughal Empire. Any decline of the Mughal Empire, any in 18th century, 18th century may characterized by the decline of Mughal Empire. Mani sabse pehla jo reason tha, wo kya tha? Decline of Mughal Empires. Mughal Empires ka patan. Understand? 18th century is the time period of the decline of Mughal Empire, rise of new independent state. Mani it is the time period of new, established a new state as a freedom. And establishment of European rule in India. And establishment of European rule in India. But thus we say that after the decline of Mughal Empire in India, established the European rule in India. Understand? So now we discuss that the 18th century is also called the phase of transition. But 18th century jo tha, wo kya tha? एक टाइम पीरियड था ट्रांजिशन, ट्रांजिशन यानी बदलाव का, यानी 18th सेंचुरी इज आल्सो कॉल्ड द पीरियड ऑफ ट्रांजिशन. इट इज कॉल्ड इन बिटवीन मिडिल एज एंड मॉडर्न एज. इट इज द टाइम पीरियड ऑफ द डिक्लाइन ऑफ मुगल एम्पायर एंड इन दैट टाइम द एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ यूरोपियन, यानी यूरोपियन रूल्स या यूरोपियन रूल्स इन इंडिया. अंडरस्टैंड? आफ्टर दैट इन द फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ this chapter, your first topic of this chapter is the later Mughal ruler. What by how many later Mughal ruler, mani jo baad ke, yani last ke antim Mughal ruler the, yani the later Mughal ruler, yani who were the later Mughal ruler? So last, mani sabse last of great Mughal emperor Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb was the last Mughal emperor of India. Aurangzeb jo tha, wo last mane India ke last, yani last Mughal ruler tha, was survived by four sons. Mane who has survived by the four sons, which led to the war of succession. Mane jahan kya tha, hamesha, yani already, yani always war of the succession. Mane hamesha उत्तराधिकार के लिए भी बहुत बड़े युद्ध यानी लड़ाई होती रहती थी. Among them मैंने आपस में, the last great Mughal ruler was the Aurangzeb and survived by the four sons, so the succession was the war of among them. Understand? बहादुर शाह first ने अमर्स विक्टोरीज, मैंने सबसे पहले अमर्स विक्टोरीज and ruled for a short period of a time. Bahadur Shah ne, mane Aurang, after the death of Aurangzeb, Bahadur Shah had ruled for a short time. Mane Bahadur Shah ne Aurangzeb ki mrityu ke baad kuch samay tak shasan kiya. Understand? He was lame. Wo kaisa tha? He was learned. Mane usne sab kuch sikha tha. He was learned. Dignified, and who tried to reverse the narrow-minded policy of his father's Aurangzeb. He also tried to a minded policy as Aurangzeb. But he ruled as his father to the Aurangzeb. But वह अपने father Aurangzeb की तरह, like as Aurangzeb की तरह ही शासन करता था. Understand? After Bahadur Shah first, Jahandar Shah, Jandar Shah and then Farukh Shiar. And then Farukh Shiar became the ruler of Nader Shah. And he became the ruler Nader Shah of Iran, invaded India. And invaded India in 1739. And Nader Shah invaded India in 1739. After that, they copied after Nader Shah, some independent rulers were Bengal, Awadh, Hyderabad emerged. मतलब हैदराबाद को भी emerged मतलब emerge कर लिया गया था. The center became weak and most important. Yet the sequence of that the center became and most important and British to conquer India. यानी British to the conquering India at that time. Understand? Now students, we discuss decline of Mughal Empire. Next is decline of Mughal Empire. कि how Mughal Empire declined, मतलब किस तरह से Mughal Empire जो थी पतन की ओर चले गए. तो the Mughal Empire began to decline, मतलब Mughal Empire started to begin in decline after the death of Aurangzeb. In 77, thus we say, in 77 after the death of Aurangzeb, all Mughal empires were weak. So some regional, any in 77, well after the death of Aurangzeb, Mughal empire began to decline. मतलब Mughal empire जो था वो पतन की ओर जाता गया. Small regional kingdoms began appearing in India. मतलब जो भी छोटे-छोटे regional kingdoms थे began appearing in India, मतलब इंडिया में appearing हो रहे थे, and there was no single unified empire. Thus we say कि there was no single unified empire, मतलब कोई भी single unified empire नहीं था. Understand? In India, in that time, a small regional kingdoms began to appear. The following causes, मतलब thus we say many causes for responsible for the decline of the Mughal Empire. In that time, India में कई causes थे जिससे decline of the Mughal Empire, मतलब Mughal Empire का धीरे-धीरे पतन होता गया. सबसे first point क्या था? Point number first, weak successes मतलब जो भी जिस उत्तराधिकारी थे वो कैसे थे? Weak थे, यानी कमजोर थे. Understood? तो his successors मतलब after the death of Aurangzeb, his successors were weak. मतलब वो कैसे थे? Weak थे and merely the puppets in the hands of noble persons and governors. मतलब all the emperor यानी all the emperor successors were very weak and the only the puppet. मतलब वह केवल उस समय nobles और governors के हाथों में क्या थे? As a puppets. मतलब puppets की तरह वर्क करते थे. Understand? Many nobles मतलब कई nobles मतलब because these emperors were weak they and the puppets in the hands of nobles. So many nobles taking advantage of the weak center, taking advantage of the weak centers, any jo bhi weak centers hote the, established their own independent kingdom. Established matlab wa apne matlab apne kingdom mein usse own independent मतलब उसने अपने ही राज में मैक्स कर लेते थे. Understand? तो first causes is the weak यानी weak successors मतलब after the death of Aurangzeb, merely emperor यानी जितने भी emperors थे वो कैसे थे? Weak थे and merely the puppet in the hands of noble and governors. Understand? That's for rivalry among the nobles. Among the nobles, mane
in that time, the emperor and Mughal emperor were the puppets of the nobles and governors. So, the other points of this topic is rivalry among the nobles. Mane jo nobles the, unme bhi aapas mein virodh tha. There were four groups among the nobles. Mane in that time, the nobles were divided into four groups based on their organ. Mane ve apni organ ke according divided into four groups mein divided the. The fraction, yani the faction, were Irans, yani jo divided the, isme Iranis, Turanis, Afghanis and Hindustanis. The nobles were that time divided into four groups. First, Iranis, second, Turanis, and third, Afghanis and Hindustanis. Understand? The next point of this topic is Curtis in Jagirdari and Mansabdari. Any Jagirdari and Mansabdari system have followed in that time. So, many criticized in that time in about Jagirdari and Mansabdari. So, towards the end of 17th century, but 17th century ke end stuff, there grew, yani there grew a paucity of Jagirdari. Mani Jagirdari mein bahut sari kamiyan aa rahi thi. Due to discriminate distribution of Jagirdari, mani Jagir means the lands given by the nobles to the farmers. Is called also Jagir. So discrimination, distribution, mane jo bhi distributions tha Jagir ka, usme kya the? Discriminate. Understand? Next, fourth point is the invasions of the Nadir Shah and Ahmad Shah Abdali. Mane Nadir Shah aur Ahmad Shah, Nadir Shah and Ahmad Shah Abdali ka jo aakman tha. So in 1739, Nadir Shah, the ruler of Iran, and Nadir Shah kaun tha? Iran ka ruler tha, invaded India and defeated the Mughal army. Invaded India, but isne India par invaded kiya and defeated the Mughal army, aur usne Mughal army se defeated. So now students, I hope you understand the many topics of this chapters. I will discuss the other topics of this chapter in next video. Thank you for attending this class.
सुस्वागतम मेरे हूँ लता पांडे संस्कृत शिक्षिका शिवाजी ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशन. बच्चों आज से आपको चैप्टर 4 बुद्धि विद्याया बुद्धि उत्तमा चैप्टर 4 विद्याया बुद्धि उत्तमा इस चैप्टर की एक्सरसाइज कराने जा रही हूँ. बच्चों एक्सरसाइज 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 तक आपको सॉल्व करा चुके. ये एक्सरसाइज नंबर 4 है. पेज नंबर है 23. ओपन योर बुक एंड सी पेज नंबर 23. ठीक है, तो देखिए एक्सरसाइज नंबर 4 में आपको करना है उचित विकल्प चुनने हैं. उचित विकल्प चुने, ठीक है. इसमें भी स्थूल पदों के आधार पे आपको उचित विकल्प चुनना है. तो बच्चों स्थूल में यानी जो आप ऐसे थिक वर्ड्स लिखे हैं आपकी बुक में, ठीक है, उसमें मैंने अंडरलाइन कर दी है. जो भी इन सेंटेंसेस में थिक वर्ड्स हैं उनमें मैंने अंडरलाइन कर दिया. आपकी बुक में अंडरलाइन नहीं है. ये थिक वर्ड्स है विद्याम चत्वारी अस्माकम चतुर्था सुमति. ठीक है, तो ये इन्हीं के स्थान पर आपको सही विकल्प चुनना है. ये क्वेश्चन मार्किंग वर्ड दिए हैं ब्रैकेट में, ठीक है. तो मैंने उचित विकल्प उसके सामने लिख दिया है. तो पहले वाले में अतिवयम विद्याम परीक्षा महे का उचित विकल्प होगा कान. दूसरा है ते चत्वारी मित्राणि अचिंतयन पर उचित विकल्प आएगा केशव। नेक्स्ट है चतुर्था सुबुद्धि अवदत् भो तिष्ठतु भवान्। यहाँ पर चतुर्था सुबुद्धि के स्थान पर उचित विकल्प आएगा का। क्लियर? तो पहला विकल्प है कान, दूसरा है कानी, तीसरा है केशाम और चौथा है का। तो ये एक्सरसाइज नंबर फोर्थ। अब आइए एक्सरसाइज नंबर फिफ्थ पर वाक्यों को घटना के अनुसार क्रम से लिखिए। ठीक है, क्रम से लिखना है, यानी जो ये स्टोरी आपने पढ़ी है विद्याया बुद्धि उत्तमा, उसमें ये लेफ्ट साइड में आपकी बुक में जो सेंटेंसेस लिखे हुए हैं वो स्टोरी के अकॉर्डिंग सीक्वेंस में नहीं है, तो आपको एक स्टोरी के अकॉर्डिंग ही क्रम से लिखना है उन वाक्यों को। तो देखिए मैंने इन वाक्यों को क्रम से लगाया है। राइट साइड में आपको पेंसिल से अपनी बुक में ये सेंटेंसेस लिखने हैं। इनका पहला क्रम है कस्मिंश्चित् नगरे चत्वारः ब्राह्मण पुत्राः आसन्। ते अचिन्तयन्। दूसरा है ते अचिन्तयन् वयं देशांतरं गत्वा धनं अर्जयाम। तीसरा संदेश बच्चों आएगा हो सुबुद्धे त्वं स्वगृहं गच्छ। नेक्स्ट है ते मार्गे एकस्य मृतस्य सिंहस्य अस्थीनि अपश्यन्। तृतीयः ब्राह्मण पुत्राः सिंहं, सॉरी यहाँ बेटा इमात्रा नहीं होगी, अच्छा सिर्फ विसर्ग होगा वरना बहुवचन हो जाएगा। तृतीयः ब्राह्मण पुत्राः सिंहं जीवितं अकरोत्। जीवनं प्राप्य सः सिंहात्रीन अपि ब्राह्मण पुत्रान् अमारयत्। ठीक है, तो इस तरह से ये छह सेंटेंसेस जो है इनको मैंने इस चैप्टर के अकॉर्डिंग क्रम से लिखा है। ऐसे ही आप भी अपनी बुक में लिखेंगे। ठीक है, नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज में एक्सरसाइज 6 अभी सॉल्व कराती हूँ। ओके, हाँ बच्चों अब देखिए एक्सरसाइज नंबर 6 विलोम शब्दों को मिलाइए। ठीक है, 1 2 3 4 5 6 ये शब्द लिखे हुए हैं और उसके बाद उनका विलोम लिखा हुआ है आपकी बुक में, आपको मैचिंग करनी है। तो उसके बाद जो उत्तर वाला ये उत्तर लिखा हुआ है, उत्तर में मैंने ये जो करेक्ट मैचिंग है वो वर्ड लिख रखे हैं, तो आपको भी उत्तर में ये शब्द लिखने हैं। बुद्धिमान का विलोम होगा बूढ़ा, पारंगता का विलोम परांगमुखा, जीवितम का विलोम मृतम, ज्येष्ठा का विलोम कनिष्ठा, आरोही का विलोम अवतीर्य, उत्तमा का विलोम अधमा। ठीक है, तो जहां उत्तर करके FIP दी हुई है वहां पर आपको ये विलोम शब्द लिखने हैं। ठीक है, नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज है बच्चों धातु और प्रत्यय अलग कीजिए। ये क्रियापद दिए हैं। ठीक है, भूत्वा प्राप्य अवतीर्य गत्वा प्राप्तुम, इस तरह से ये क्रियापद है। अब ये भूत्वा शब्द में आपको ये बताना है कि इसमें धातु कौन सी है, प्रत्यय कौन सा है या उपसर्ग कौन सा लगा हुआ है। ये इस तरह से उपसर्ग धातु प्रत्यय ये तीन कॉलम दिए गए हैं, तो आपको इन शब्दों से धातु प्रत्यय और उपसर्ग अलग करके लिखना है। जैसे भूत्वा शब्द में उपसर्ग कोई नहीं है, धातु है भू, प्रत्यय कत्वा। प्राप्य में प्राउपसर्ग है, आप धातु है, लेप प्रत्यय है। अवतीर्य में कोई भी, सॉरी अवतीर्य में अव उपसर्ग होना चाहिए, अव। ठीक है, अव उपसर्ग होगा, त्रि धातु है, लेप प्रत्यय है। गत्वा में कोई भी उपसर्ग नहीं है, गम धातु कत्वा प्रत्यय। प्राप्तुम में प्राउपसर्ग, आप धातु तुमुन प्रत्यय। कृत्वा में कोई उपसर्ग नहीं है, त्रि धातु कत्वा प्रत्यय। अर्जयतुम में कोई उपसर्ग नहीं है, अर्ज धातु तुमुन प्रत्यय। गृहित्वा में कोई उपसर्ग नहीं है, गृह धातु कत्वा प्रत्यय है। विचिंत में भी उपसर्ग है, चिंत धातु है और लिया करते हैं। तो इस तरह से बच्चों ये जो क्रियापद दिए हुए थे इनसे मैंने आपको ये बताया है कि उपसर्ग कौन सा है, धातु कौन सी है और प्रत्यय कौन सा है। ठीक है, तो इस तरह से ये एक्सरसाइज नंबर 7 कंप्लीट हो गई। ठीक है, ये एक्सरसाइज नंबर 6 और ये एक्सरसाइज नंबर 7। ओके, अब आइए लास्ट एक्सरसाइज जो है एक्सरसाइज नंबर 8, वो मैं सॉल्व करा रही हूं। ये लास्ट एक्सरसाइज है बच्चों, इसके प्रश्न है एक पदेन उत्तरत, एक पदेन उत्तरत। ठीक है, ये है तो इसमें पहले का ऑप्शन है ते मृतस्य सिंहस्य कानि पश्यन्। ये पहला इसका क्वेश्चन है कानि अपश्यन्, तो इसका करेक्ट ऑप्शन होगा अस्थीन, अस्थीन यानी हड्डियां। ठीक है, इसे आप टिक करें, अस्थीन को टिक मार्क लगाएंगे। ठीक है, दूसरा है ब्राह्मण पुत्रा कम जीवितम, ब्राह्मण पुत्रा कम जीवितम कर्तुम इच्छन्ति, यानी ब्राह्मण पुत्र किसे जीवित करना चाहते थे, तो आप लिखेंगे सिंहम, करेक्ट ऑप्शन होगा सिंहम। ठीक है, इसी का सेकंड नंबर देखें, पूर्ण वाक्येन उत्तरत, यानी पूर्ण वाक्य में उत्तर दीजिए। द्वितीय ब्राह्मण पुत्रा किम अकरोत्, द्वितीय ब्राह्मण पुत्रा किम अकरोत्, इसका पूर्ण वाक्य में उत्तर देना है, तो आप लिखेंगे द्वितीय ब्राह्मण पुत्रा चर्म मांस रुधिरम। ठीक है, चर्म मांस रुधिरम संयोजितवान, ठीक है, ये इसका आंसर है। अब इसका थर्ड देखें, थर्ड पार्ट क्या है, भाष्यकार है द्वितीय शब्द से का विलोमम, तो आप फर्स्ट ऑप्शन आंसर लिखेंगे प्रथमा। ठीक है, इसको टिक करेंगे। और दूसरा है अद्य विद्याम परीक्षा महे वाक्य का अभ्यास शब्द, इस वाक्य में कौन सा अभ्यास शब्द है, तो करेक्ट ऑप्शन होगा अद्य। ठीक है, इसे आप करेंगे, समझ रहे। तो इस तरह से बच्चों एक पदेन उत्तरत, फिर से आप देखें ते मृतस्य सिंहस्य कानि पश्यन्, तो इसका करेक्ट ऑप्शन होगा अस्थीन। ब्राह्मण पुत्रा कम जीवितम कर्तुम इच्छन्ति, करेक्ट ऑप्शन है सिंह, क्लियर। अब इसका सेकंड देखिए आप, पूर्ण वाक्य उत्तर, पूर्ण वाक्य में उत्तर दीजिए, अभिजीतवान यानी दूसरे ब्राह्मण पुत्र ने चर्म मांस और रक्त एकत्र किया। भाषिक कार्य में पहले का करेक्ट ऑप्शन है प्रथमा, दूसरे का करेक्ट ऑप्शन है आदि। ठीक है, तो इस तरह से आज बच्चों विद्याया बुद्धि उत्तमा का ये अनुशीलन यानी अभ्यास कार्य कंप्लीट हो गया है। सभी बच्चे शब्दार्थ जरूर याद करें, मैं हमेशा कहती हूँ ये बात आपको तब समझ में आएगी जब आप शब्दार्थ याद करने के बाद अर्थ पढ़ेंगे, तो आपको लगेगा कि अरे वाह ये तो बहुत आसानी से समझ में आ रहा है। इसलिए शब्दार्थ याद करें, अर्थ लिखें और ये जो अनुशीलन यानी एक्सरसाइज है इसको आप अपनी बुक में फिर से करें लेकिन पेंसिल से। ठीक है, कोई भी बच्चा पेन का यूज बुक में ना करे, बहुत गंदा लगता है और ये भी मुश्किल होती है जब आप कुछ इनकरेक्ट कर देते हैं तो फिर उसे इरेज नहीं कर पाते, पेंसिल से होता है तो इरेज कर लेते हैं, तो इसलिए आप पेंसिल से ही बुक में एक्सरसाइज फिल करें। तो इस तरह से बच्चों आज ये चैप्टर फिनिश हो गया है विद्याया बुद्धि उत्तमः। नेक्स्ट वीडियो